Hey there, Lincoln County. This is Dr. Allen coming to you this week for your Lincoln County Schools Core Communication for August the 25th, 2023. I am joined by my guest, Thomas LaVerde. He is our SRO supervisor for Lincoln County Schools and the Lincoln County Sheriff's Department. We'll talk to Thomas here in a second. Some things that we have coming up this week that I need to make sure you're aware of. In our elementary and middle schools, we have our iReady assessment going on this week coming up. Or we've had it this week and we'll continue into next week to make sure we have those assessments for the beginning of the year completed so we can help your child grow from there. Great start overall. As we think about the first 8 days of school, we've had very few hiccups, but I do appreciate the parents that have sent us their feedback, ways we can improve with some traffic, with some communication, and with some overall operations within the schools. I appreciate the feedback there. Parents, this is a chance for me to remind you that you can visit the Lincoln County Schools website at www.lcsnc.org, and you click on the parent-student tab, and that will take you to the parent-student handbook for you to look at. And it's also in Spanish for you to review as well if that is something that you need as a resource. Our bus routes, just a reminder, the general rule of thumb is students need to be at bus routes 10 minutes before the printed stop, just to make sure that we're there ready for the bus, but also to know that the buses could be up to 10 minutes later depending on traffic and other things going on. So just still work with us as we clean up those stop times and on our bus routes. Also, parents, you should have been receiving some emails from PowerSchool that ask you to update your contact information for your child in PowerSchool. This is very important that we want to make sure we have enough information in PowerSchool that's updated and accurate. So make sure you complete that process, please. And then last but not least, remember that our cafeteria menus for our elementary, middle, and high are posted on our Lincoln County Schools website under Child Nutrition. I know a lot of our schools repost those on their social media platforms, just so you're aware of all the things that we offer for breakfast and lunch each day. So with that, we do have a change in our operations this year. Specifically, you've heard in some of the news articles on TV and in the newspaper, we've added elementary school SROs this year, thanks to our commissioners funding that for all of our elementary schools, both in the city and in the county. So Thomas is here to talk us through basically what is an SRO.
Well, first of all, thank you for having me, Dr. Allen. An SRO is exactly what our title stands for. We're a school resource officer. And that's the first and foremost thing that we are to the staff and the students, is that we're a resource. Obviously we have a badge and we have a duty, but we want to help the students and the staff with whatever they might be going on throughout that day.
Okay, good. And that really is no different between elementary, middle, and high. The definition you gave is very applicable to all three levels. It's just that at each different level, you may react differently based on the situation.
Yes.
So let's talk about if a parent or somebody in the community comes into the schools, what would they see on a daily basis from the SRO interacting within the school day?
So our main priority is to be visible within the school building. So you're going to see the officers walking around, interacting with students, encouraging them to get to class on time. At our elementary buildings, we have helped the students get out of the car line. You'll see them interacting with the staff, just overall, just getting as involved as much as we can with the community.
Okay, and in some situations, they're directing traffic in some instances, but also they're assisting administrators when there are criminal issues that have taken place. So they're there as a direct resource. And then of course, they're there to provide that first line of defense in the event that there's something that's going on wrong at the school. By doing that, you have to go through certain trainings before you're allowed to become a school resource officer. Talk about what that looks like.
So that is our number one priority, if you were to list it, is the safety of the school, the staff, the students. And as a resource officer, even to become a school resource officer, the state mandates a certification that you have to obtain, and you have to have certain criteria to even be eligible to be a school resource officer. Even when those boxes are checked, at Lincoln County Sheriff's Office, we do multiple solo shooter response trainings. Lord forbid anything like that might occur.
Yeah.
But we still want to do our part in sharpening the edges in case we have to react in the situation.
Yeah. So I do want to appreciate the fact that our city and our sheriff's office, City PD and Sheriff's Office, work well together in this joint effort to keep all of our schools. It's all 23 of Lincoln County schools. It's the charter school campuses, and it's some of the private school campuses.
Correct.
All have resource officers staffed by either department. And so it does take some coordination. That's why we have a supervisor over that to coordinate that for the sheriff. And I appreciate the leadership that the commissioners have shown, but also the sheriff and his deputies have shown in making sure that our campuses are safe for our staff and our students, and helping parents have a little bit more of a mindful ease of mind, so to speak, of their child and their staff and their spouse may be safer at school. So Thomas, think about if you ran into somebody at Walmart and somebody talked about some just general tips in today's world of how you can give them one or two nuggets about how to help their kid be safer in today's society, what would you offer up?
One of the first things is, if you see something, say something. That's one of the biggest key things here. This isn't a sheriff's office problem or a school problem. This is a community problem if it ever gets to that level. So we kind of got to work together, encourage some of those barriers that might have been there in the past to kind of step over them, get to know the officers again, are there to build those relationships. So when those relationships get built, obviously they'll start sharing some information. So first I would say, if you see something, say something. We're not going to blast your information out there. We just want to be as prepared as possible. And then second, just understand that we are going to do everything we can to protect the school building and the staff and students. We're training all the officers that I have met with the city, as well as obviously with the sheriff's office, are excited and are motivated to protect the kids. And we just look at this as a blessing.
It is definitely is a blessing. And so parents, with that, if you have any questions about school safety, check in with your administrators. We also have Chief of Operations Eric Aker, who works with Thomas routinely and reviews reports, and to make sure that we are doing all that we can to keep your child and your spouse and our staff safe on our campuses. Thank you, Thomas, for joining us. A couple more things, folks. Tonight, Lincoln will travel to North Lincoln and take it on the Knights at home. So look for a good Lincoln County crowd to show up and cheer on their favorite team. West Lincoln travels to Cherville tonight to take on the Ironmen, and East Lincoln will travel to Forest View to take on the Jaguars. If you look also ahead, on the 30th of August, we will begin our third grade beginning of the year assessments for parents. That'll be their beginning of the year test that the state will use to compare their growth for the end of the year. That will start on the 30th of August. That's it for the announcements for this week. I appreciate you joining us and looking into what's going on in Lincoln County. Parents, remember to help us to help your children remember what it means to be safe and to be kind to others in our actions and our words. Y'all take care.